The next item is 90.2A. This is a public hearing on the Mayor's Preliminary Budget 2011-2012. This is a legislative type of public hearing. It is not quasi-judicial in nature. Since there may be an extensive list of people who would like to speak in this, we'll ask you again to keep to the 3 minutes, if you will. Please be concise. Excuse me. Goodness. And try to allow time for others to comment, which by 3 minutes, I think we'll have plenty of time for that. Everyone present will be given an opportunity to be heard. All persons wishing to be heard at the public hearing should sign up on the sign-up sheet, which we do have one or two people. And then other than that, we'll just go through. We'll just start again and move across to, for people who want to raise their hand and speak on the budget issue. Any person who does not sign up, of course, will have the opportunity to simply raise your hand and be recognized. At this time, I'd open the hearing with regard to the Mayor's Preliminary Budget 2011-12. That is now open. And the purpose is for the City Council, of course, to hear testimony on the decisions that they'll be coming up with in a couple weeks with regard to taking final action on the budget. Let's see. An official record is being made of what is said. Therefore, when you come to the microphone, please give your name, your address, and state what you want to in the time limit. Please speak slowly and clearly into the microphone. Only one person speaks at a time. And under state law, this is a time for us to receive the comment. It's not a time for us to engage in any sort of back and forth or questions and answers. There's an appropriate place for that near the end of the sequence. The order of speaking will be as follows. A staff presentation by the Interim Finance Director will introduce the general topic, if you will. Testimony from the public, either in support of or neutral to, and we'll go through and select people in the sequence in which they raise their hands unless there's a need to move to opposing and proposal speakers. Any testimony from staff in response to the testimony, there's the things that they need to have said. Then fourth, the City Council will then have an opportunity to ask questions. At the conclusion of that, there will be an opportunity for any person in the audience to clarify or to respond to a very specific point that was raised. We need to look at the funnel of funneling this down, where at that time, if there's something that you need to say sort of in rebuttal to what has been said, that'd be fine. No new points would be brought up at that time. At this time, I'd like to call upon the Interim Finance Director, Patrick Dugan, who has a brief presentation to sort of introduce this topic again. And this is the last hearing required by law before the council can take action on this particular budget. Director Dugan.
Honorable Mayor, members of the council, it's a pleasure to address you tonight on this important topic before the city. This is a outline of the process that we have went through in public hearings to get to this point. I've used this slide or some version of it since we started back in June, and in June the first bullet was red, and now we're down to almost the last bullet in red, showing where we've stopped, where we're at now. This hearing was originally scheduled on November 22nd, but due to weather, it had to be continued to tonight. It is actually one of three interconnected hearings, and that might be a little confusing, but these are separate hearings that we need to have for different kinds of purposes. First, there is the mayor, as the mayor indicated, a final hearing on the preliminary budget. And then there is a hearing on revenues that are proposed to be used in the budget. This hearing is required as part of the process of levying property taxes, but it is on all revenues that are being used on the in the budget so that people can react to any one of those revenue sources in their testimony. And then a hearing on the capital facilities plan. And finally, but by the end of the year, the council deliberations will occur and a budget will be adopted by law. There are several budget documents that we need to keep in mind. First, the proposed preliminary budget, which was issued September 13th, which identified the needs of the departments to maintain current levels of services. And even though that budget is not required to be balanced, we identified a series of cuts that would reduce the needs identified by the departments down to the available revenues. The next document was the preliminary budget, known by the initials of PB, and the mayor's budget message. That was issued on November 1st. It incorporates both potential service reductions and potential new revenues to produce a balanced budget. After the mayor issued his budget, the council formed a work group which has tendered its own recommendations, basically proposing an alternative approach to the budget. And finally, there will be the final budget, which would be adopted by the city council after considering the preliminary budget and the council work group recommendations. I always like to remind everybody how we got to the point of where we have to look at these types of cuts. And this graph, I think, summarizes it in a nutshell, and it might potentially be the last time you'll see it. The basic problem is that since 2007, we have lost $4.3 million per year in sales tax revenue, while personnel costs have increased by $5.5 million. That in a nutshell. A lot of other things go on around it, but that is the essence of our budget problem. On the basis of looking at the original proposed preliminary budget, as I indicated, we identified new general fund revenues of $87.3 million being available to support city operations next year, but the estimated preliminary budget to maintain the current level of services together with other fiscal measures required $108.9 million, creating a $2.6 million gap in the proposed preliminary budget.
21.6. You said 2.6 million.
21.6 million. I'm sorry.
We're hoping.
Yeah, well.
I was ready to go home.
I wish so too. Yeah. So where we're at now is, as I indicated, the preliminary budget, which was balanced, proposing one way to close that $21.6 million gap, was proposed on November 1st. Public hearing was held on that on November 8th. Meanwhile, the council set up a work group to develop recommendations regarding their own approach to balancing the budget. The work group issued its report on November 10th. So in effect, there are two budget alternatives, which I will contrast with this slide. Comparing in the middle column, the preliminary budget and budget mayor's budget message with the council work group's recommendations. Both of them looked at new revenues. In the case of the preliminary budget and the budget message, $6 million. In the case of the council work group, $7.4 million distributed as identified below. The mayor proposed a 3% property tax increase. The council called for using all bank capacity, which resulted in an 11.5% increase. The mayor proposed a $100 per employee business license fee. The council work group has proposed an $85 fee. Both of them have recommended an increase of all utility taxes to 6%. These topics will be addressed in my presentation in greater detail on the revenue hearing, but this summarizes it. Based on those revenue initiatives, the expenses are contrasted by the council work group proposing $1.3 million in savings in labor concessions over the biennium, and the mayor's budget did not program those types of savings. The amount of restored cuts and because of the increased revenue in the council work group recommendation and the savings in labor concessions, the council was able to restore $12 million in the biennium of the proposed cuts in the proposed preliminary budget. That was 54% of the potential cuts that were identified in the proposed preliminary budget. The mayor, in contrast, budget would restore $7.9 million, focused primarily on public safety, and that's 36% of the potential cuts. So with that, I'd be happy to turn it over for public comment.
Thank you.